action step number 4. Let's keep grinding. You excited? You excited? Listen, I'm excited. You know why? Because one day I'm going to get to meet you. One day you're going to come up to me. You're going to see me at a rodeo and you're going to be like, listen, this is where I'm at. And you'll have in your pocket what your goals are, because that's what I used to do. I put my goals literally in my pocket, and I'd focus on what my big goals were for rodeo, but then out in the other pocket, I had a simple piece of paper, and I wrote down what my goal was for this rodeo, okay? What it's gonna do with my feet, what it's gonna do with my mind, and that was the goal, and I have them both in my shirt pocket, and man, that made a difference. One day, I'm gonna meet you at a rodeo, and you're gonna show me that, and you're gonna be like, yes, my dreams are coming true. You can do this. Okay, action step number 4, guys. Okay, my question is, what action do you need to take? Because the last video we talked about what's stopping you, and you wrote it down, and you got it clear. Now, what action steps do you need to take? And I'm gonna help you out, okay? I wrote them down here on this little whiteboard. I have 7 action steps, okay? That are crucial, that are a must for champions to be created, for champions to be built. Step 1 is fitness, okay? You just have to do it. It's a given. It is a given, okay? Fitness is coming to rodeo, and if you're not doing fitness, guys, you're gonna be left in the dust. It's that simple. Don't be left in the dust. Be one of the pioneers. Be one of the first. Be the guy that grinds. Now, I don't mean that you got to go to the gym for an hour and a half to grind, but I'm just talking general fitness, push-ups, sit-ups, jumping jacks, the simple things that I'm going to be giving you, or I'm giving you guys along your journey, but you've got to take care of your bodies, because we put our bodies through a lot of stuff, okay? A lot of rigmarole, okay? Right here, guys, it's rodeo fit, okay? Fitness. It's that time. If you're not made that commitment yet, you got to start making that commitment in your mind. We got to start working you on consistency, okay? You want consistency in your riding? You be consistent in your daily routine. When I was riding, I used to do 50 push-ups in the morning, 50 push-ups at night, 50 leg lifts in the morning, 50 leg lifts at night, and I'd ride my spur board, okay? That was a given. Didn't matter if I was sick, the flu, broken arm. I never broke my arm. But anyways, as I made no excuses, okay? And the fitness right there, that is huge, okay? So action step, put it down, write it down. You write it down, or you post a comment after this, say, yep, I need my fitness. You're right, I need my fitness, okay? Agility, this is huge. Agility, guys. I wanna talk about agility. Balance, 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 balance. You should have one of these, and literally you should just ride this thing all the time and get comfortable with it. If you watch TV, you should be on this thing and just have this thing mastered to where you can just get on it no problem at all. That's agility. That's a must, 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 okay? Bull riding, it's a balance game. Bareback riding, it is a balance game, but bareback riding is a kicking contest. Saddlebuck riding, it's a big time balance game, a timing game, and a kicking game as well. Agility, coordination, okay? The drills, you gotta be doing coordination drills. Rodeo happens so fast. It's not like a football game where you go, okay, the play is 10, 15 seconds long, then you go back to the huddle and then you regroup and do it again. No, it happens way too fast. You gotta have the agility, you gotta have the coordination. Third thing, you gotta have speed, okay? Reaction time. Your reaction time has to be ridiculous. Your reaction time has to be sick, okay? Has to be sick, 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 okay? Because you're trying to outdo these animals, and their reaction and their speed is so darn fast. If right now you're slow, you can change that. You can change it by grinding. You can change it by doing my speed reaction drills. Speed it up, okay? Definitely, I got it covered. Got you handled on that one. Fourth one, guys, is actual groundwork, okay? Now, this first 3, we're talking about just the physical, just the fitness, okay? Working on your body, getting your muscles in shape. Now, when we're talking about actually groundwork, we're talking about riding your spur board. If you're a bareback rider and you don't have a spur board, why not, okay? You can go to the hardware store and you can build one for about $20, okay? I also have spur boards, spur machines that I built. They're revolutionary. They're beyond amazing. They're a game changer. They teach you how to lift on your handle, lift on your feet. Okay, they're awesome. And you can see that in the description later during this training. I'm not here to sell you one, but I'm here to just tell you it's a must. I'm so tired of talking to bareback riders and bull riders, and they're like, I don't have a buck in my own. Wait, hold on, time out. You're telling me, okay, do you go all week long and go to school or go to your job and then you just go to the weekend and ride? No go. I was a wrestler since first grade. I was in football since fourth grade, okay? You had wrestling practice, football practice, 5 days a week, 2 hour days. You go, you practice, and then you go on the weekends and you compete. Same thing in rodeo, okay? You don't have to do it. Maybe you're not doing it right now. But maybe all of a sudden what I'm explaining to you, you're like, wait a minute. Oh my gosh, wait, for real? Is that what makes the difference? Mm-hmm, that's what makes the difference. You grind during the week, because when you show up on the weekend, you ground so hard during the week and nobody else is ground, okay? You've worked your butt off mentally, physically, spiritually. You are ready and you go to the winner's circle. Becoming a rodeo champion isn't about getting lucky. It's not about wishing. It's about working for it. Groundwork, okay? Now this is just a checklist. This right here is a diagnostic of you, your rodeo career, your riding, okay? So if you're doing none of these, it's okay, don't feel bad, but make it spur you, okay? I'm here to spur you in action. Go, oh man, okay, I can do this, and I can do this, and I need to do this, and groundwork, yeah, I need to do that as well, okay? And then right here, what we're doing right now, the mindset. That is the most important training you can ever, ever, ever do every single day, okay? You should be listening to something that's building up your mind on a daily basis. You should be listening to my podcast. You should be listening to, and not just me, you need to find Tony Robbins, Les Brown, E.T. Fletcher, okay? All these motivational guys, these guys that literally they are building your mind up. You should be conditioning and feeding your mind every single day. Because when I started doing that, game changed for me, guys. Mindset. And then sponsorship, okay? You need to be working on the sponsorships. How do you work on sponsorships? You first can go to your parents' companies that they work for and you ask them. Then you go to your friends and your friends' parents and you start asking them. And you start talking to the local businesses in town that you know, and you just go ask. You just go ask. Gold's Gym did not come to me and say, you know what, we're gonna sponsor you. We're gonna give you tens of thousands of dollars. This is gonna be awesome. No go, okay? I got big enough reasons, big enough goals that I wrote down and then confident, okay? And I strolled in there, arms back, shoulders back, chin up, and I just looked at him and asked him for a sponsorship with confidence, not arrogance, with confidence. And I'll never forget, after they wrote me that big check, they said, do you know why we sponsored you? I was like, oh, you guys are into rodeo. They're like, no, we're not into rodeo. We're into the gym business to get people in shape. But they said, we sponsored you. We want to be a part of you. You're doing something big. You're doing something great. You're going somewhere. You're making something of yourself. We want to be a part of your journey. Invite people in, okay? You should be posting on your social media, inviting them and saying, hey, listen, here's my goals. Here's what I've done in the past. Here's where I'm going. I want to win. If you want to help me out, if you know someone or a company or sponsor, I'll take $20, $50, $80, $100, $500, whatever it may be, okay? Just start asking. Because one time I asked this five-time world champ bareback rider, I was like, man, during your career, I bet, you know, Bruce Ford, I said, I bet you've got a lot of sponsorships in your days. And he said, never had one. Zero. None. I was like, are you kidding me? He goes, yeah, I thought after becoming a world champion that I would have these companies come to me and want to sponsor me. Nope. You got to go get the sponsors, okay? Start asking. And last thing right here, team, okay? Stop doing rodeo alone. I know you go down the road with your buddies, or maybe you don't go down the road with your buddies. You need to get some buddies. But that's why we're here. That's why we're on this phone app, okay? We're doing this together, and we're a team. You got to introduce yourself to other guys on this training app. Start collaborating with them. Start sharing ideas and secrets and tips and tricks or whatever. We're all in this together. We're all competing against these animals, these beasts, okay? okay, that are 1,200, 1,800 pound bulls. We're competing against them. Let's pull together as a team. Let's work together as a team. So once you get done watching this video, I want you to go and friend and follow all the people that ride your event, okay? And just say hi. Hey, you know what? Boom. Here it is. Yeah, let's work together. Let's pull together. Don't do rodeo alone. Because everybody, doesn't matter what level somebody's riding at, there's something that they could share with you, and you'd be like, ooh, I didn't know that. Or a lot of times they'll share something with you and you'd be like, oh, I used to do that and I don't do that anymore, okay? Woo, there it is right there. Those are the action steps. I wrote them down for you. I'm gonna show you one more time right there. Fitness, agility, speed, groundwork, mindset, sponsorship, teamwork. There it is right there, okay? You start to feel confident? Yeah, getting those shoulders back, head up, chin up, okay? Yeah, this is feeling good. All right, you're gonna see me in the next video. Woo, that's what I'm talking about. Those are the action steps. Write it down, post a comment, write it down in the comments or on a piece of paper, the action that you're gonna take. Go for it right now.